Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Just wanted to see. People, you know, they have a lot of fun sometimes, or at least, you know, in third grade they did try to make their voice go as low as it possibly can. What am I supposed to do about that? This is as low as my voice possibly goes. It's also as, you know, high as my voice possibly goes. It's just, you know, I stay right around here. I'm part of the MTV generation. It is gonna be nice, that minus five is due to a lost run. It is gonna be nice, we're just gonna random here. You know what? I'm gonna put it back on normal mode for now. We'll do hard mode runs for the lost. Fuck it, we're here already. Let's just do it. Here's our seed. I wanna mix it up a little bit to keep morale up. It's gonna be very nice. N1KW XB Rock with a Q. Rokay. It's gonna be nice to have a run where I can actually take damage. I'm pretty excited about that. It's gonna be nice to have a run where we can reroll shoot to whoop. What a piece of trash. And then we get Spider Butt, which is, like, almost, well, I wouldn't say equivalent. I think Spider Butt is a little bit better. They're both not very good, though. And with, like, 300 items in the game, it's not like we're taking them out of the rotation to get something better. Let's be honest, they're probably not going to come back anyway. For a second, I thought they were completely closed in the middle there, and I was like, how am I supposed to get these guys? It's okay. It's going to be annoying, though. But it doesn't matter if we get hit. Life's good. I am pretty excited about the fact that we got this Temperance card. That would have ended our lost run right there. It's nice we can play a little bit sloppier, which I know sounds like an excuse, but it is unreasonable to have a run that just doesn't allow you to take damage. So, I don't mind having a run. You know we have a health bar for a reason, and I don't think this is going to make us any sloppier for our lost play. If anything, I think it's kind of like playing Spelunky. In Spelunky, one mistake can mean that you die. Playing as the lost means that one mistake means you're probably going to die. Not always in Spelunky will you die with one mistake, but often, that's all it takes. But, you know, like, the first run you do with the lost has a decent chance. The second run you do, decent chance. Third run, decent chance. After that, I start to find my morale, drops pretty damn quickly, and I'm like, oh, I don't want to live on this planet anymore. That's okay, though. We'll be alright. We'll be trying to work out those last few kind of like lost achievements and then actually getting those items. In the meantime, we do also have a secondary thing to focus on. We need to make sure that we get to 999 cents. Apparently you unlock an item at that level that makes the game a little bit easier. Which would be very useful if you were trying to, say, beat Boss Rush and the Dark Room as the lost. And we're not able to get hit at all. So hopefully we can make that happen. We're only one room away from getting our D6 reroll, but let's fight whoever our first boss is first. It's Duke of Flies. Just try not to get him to move so we can actually plan where to place a bomb. And that has worked fantastically. We'll just eke out the rest of his damage with our tears. Then we'll probably... It's a tough one. Wait, we don't have a second boss here. It's just an absurdly large single floor. Okay. Never mind. I was like, we have a second... boss to fight, and then we might be able to reroll a deal with the devil if he gets so lucky. But no, this is just a really, really big first floor. I recalled having a curse. I didn't know whether it was Curse of the Lost or Curse of the Labyrinth. This is okay. So we are going to come back here and certainly reroll our spider butt. Becomes chocolate milk, and you know what? I'll take it. I don't have a problem with chocolate milk anymore so much. I don't like to tap shoot it still, but if we're just going to be doing charge shots, that's okay. Extra key, that makes me feel pretty good. A bit of a weird situation, because I would love to use this Temperance card on this floor to get a blood bank theoretically spawned on the next floor, but we don't have any red hearts kind of waiting around for us, so I think we're actually much better off taking this Temperance card down with us. I'm actually going to use a bomb here as well to try to find the second secret room. It wasn't there, that's alright, we can get a Tinted Rock on the next floor. And let's move along. Chocolate milk has some interesting synergies, interesting combinations with other items as well. And I didn't give it very much respect in vanilla, so I kind of want to give it a little bit more respect now. Curse room. I'm not going to go to it yet, but it is going to make up an important part of our methodology here. Tomo, you're not going to go in the window, buddy, but you just spent all that time getting into the window. You weirdo. I am hoping that, you know, maybe if we get like one guppy item, don't tease us. Like, let us... Tomato, bacon, those are the ingredients for a TLB sandwich. I think I invented it. Sincerely, though, like, don't tease us with the whole guppy action, you know? Let us become guppy if you're going to give us a couple guppy items. We've been trying so much lately, and it just hasn't worked out. I'll come back and shoot this poop if it is necessary, or if we get petrified poop. We may get the requisite amount of money regardless. That's what I was looking for right there. Slow him down. I don't know why. I guess, like, here's what chocolate milk made me think in vanilla was like, well, first off, it hurt my wrist to do it, so there's no question that I was just not going to do it very much. But I think it was because I was tap shooting too much, because I was like, we need to get a high rate of fire. When in reality, you know, the benefit of chocolate milk is kind of treating it like a shittier tier-based version of Mom's Knife, I think. And, you know, you charge up a shot, you hit an enemy with it, if your damage is good enough, you take him out in one hit. It's not effectively that much different than Mom's Knife. It is a lot worse, because you don't have a huge damage bonus as a result of using it, but, you know, if you just use it kind of the way nature intended, I think you're going to be fine. Guillotine is not good. It's not a good item. So I rerolled it, and I picked up Strange Attractor instead. I don't think Guillotine's bad, by the way, I just don't think it's good. I picked up Strange Attractor, which is also not a good item. But the reason I picked it up is because we're going to be short on rerolls, and what can I say? I'm a sucker for weird items. And I know that, or at least I have a strong hunch, that there would be a battery in here. And there is. So we know for 5 cents we can get a reroll that we could bring into our... Trying to find Tinted Rocks, but on Curse of Darkness is a little tricky. For 5 cents, we can get a reroll that we can bring into our boss fight and our deal with the devil if we are so inclined. Doesn't look likely that we'll be able to get it without it, so wouldn't surprise me if that's what we do end up doing. We have the compass as well. How do I feel about the compass? I think I haven't used it that much in Rebirth. I think I kind of overvalued it. I mean, it was really good in vanilla, but I think maybe I overvalue it in Rebirth as a result of the... Hey, come back, come back. You're going to need to come back, please? If I get shot by one of these fires, I'm going to be so mad. All right, so we haven't taken red heart damage yet on this floor. So I am going to go back and buy this battery to get a full charge on our D6. Don't walk into anything by accident here. And you know what? The first deal with the devil, like, if there's anything that I've come to appreciate in Rebirth, it's really that this first deal with the devil, I used to think it was of critical importance. Now, I almost would go further and say it's like the be-all, end-all. I would spend all of our money every time to guarantee a deal with the devil. Now, we probably didn't need to spend it, because we're going up against Monstro, you know, no big deal. So we're going to try to hit him. Whenever he's, like, walking, we'll hit him with, like, one big shot, then we'll tap, tap, tap it in. Hoping to use this temperance card. I mean, even on this floor, we could even use it to help us get into the curse room, spending a little bit less HP in the process, I think. Sometimes the game's not very nice about letting you do stuff like that, though. So that was a very easy fight. We got Synth Oil, which is great, and then our deal with the devil. So, you know, I understand the value of Book of Belial, but I think I'm going to reroll both of these. And I will take 9 lives. But I know. I value Guppy too much, though. And I think we're going to sacrifice... we haven't picked up any HP, so I don't feel like that's a really big loss. And I wish there was, like, a trinket, and it just destroyed all the poop as soon as you finished a room. That would be, like... It's the perfect Northern Lion trinket. The perfect Northern Lion trinket from Cinco. No, but it really would be, like, the perfect trinket for me. Because it's... It gives you no benefit from a gameplay standpoint, but it rewards you, or at least doesn't punish you as much if you're as lazy as I am. Man, not having any bombs is a real pain in the ass here. Those pots could give me, well, they could give me a quarter, of course, but they could also just... Okay, I don't know why I'm getting so lucky with this, but I am. I guess I don't really need to buy anything. And now I don't need to use the temperance card on this floor because we actually have enough money to spawn a blood bank in the future anyway. Yeah, but it won't be on the next floor. So let's sacrifice our spirit heart to go into this room. Bomb, actually? Yeah, okay, so we'll see what's in this middle chest. 2 bombs and, some keys. Well, you know what? I would like to get the... well, where could a secret room be? Could really only be here. Yeah, or that one in the middle, but the one in the middle seems blocked off by rocks. See what we got in here. 6 cents, okay. That was a good use of a bomb, I'd say. Well, if we get 3 more cents, we can buy compass. I don't really want to buy red candle. Let's put a bomb down here and see if we can get the 3 cents necessary. Alrighty then. We could play temperance and get the compass. Is that really worth it? I mean, there's value in it. I guess I'm quite clearly not going to be going to boss rush on this run. Oh, well. You know what? I'll buy the compass. I'll go back and buy the compass. Because, oh, right. I forgot that we have the monkey's paw. That's actually, it's great. It gave us a black heart in exchange there. I'll buy the compass, and the reason I'll buy the compass is because it'll help us plan rerolls out for the future. Okay? Sue me. We'll probably be able to donate on a or an upcoming floor. I apologize for this being a very slow run to start with here, but I mean, you can understand the value, I think. We could probably play like nearly indefinitely with Monkey's Paw. I think I just got rid of my red hearts, so now I can't, but hey, that's all right. We got 9 lives on this floor. We got a damage upgrade in the form of synth oil. We got the compass. We got Strange Attractor, which a lot of people would probably consider bad. Maybe myself included. Haven't fully decided on that one yet. I think it's really good when it's really good. Sorry, let me rephrase it in a way that is not just self-evident. When it's good, it's really good. When it's bad, it's really bad. Like, a smell. I don't know, like, I guess you can have mildly pleasant smells, but I don't think it happens that often. Oh, okay, that's great. Guppy's collar showing up gives us a very realistic chance of becoming Guppy. Especially, we're only on the third floor. I don't think chocolate milk has any particular synergy with Strange Attractor, but that might be the best kind of synergy because we don't have to worry about it. Okay, Ludovico technique, chocolate milk. How does this even work? It's like the more I move it, the bigger it gets. No, it just seems to stay the same size. But again, my whole, you know, MO in Isaac is weird shit. And this is definitely some weird shit we got going on here. And I like that a lot. Now, it looks like our rerolls are... Oh, come on. You're gonna jump out of that nonsense? We still do have a black heart. So, worst case scenario, we get hit one more time. And then our black hearts, procs. And, well, not procs. You know what I mean. Activates. Kills these enemies. Thank you. And the cool thing about what we got going on here is that... Anti-grav Ludo, or not anti-grav, sorry, but Dark Strange Attractor and Ludo will suck enemies in to a point that I create. So I could create it like near fires or something like that and help out. Jesus juice is extra damage. I appreciate it. I don't think the range really does anything for us, but damage upgrades are going to be, you know, very nice. I'm actually going to do this because I think I was at half of a red heart. So this will put me at a full red heart. And being at a full red heart means I can actually go into this curse room as long as I have this half black heart available. So why don't we do that right now just to see if we can make the Guppy dream become a reality right away. Alright. Can't always get what you want, of course. I've got to admit, it seems a little wonky. The Ludo interactions here seem a little wonky. Yeah, we're half of a red heart shy now. But that's not necessarily a bad thing indefinitely. It's just a little weird. Try to buy a spirit heart up here. No excuse to walk into those guys. Just try to stay as far away. Like, the bomb ones are not the most annoying here. Yeah, actually, like, Ludo anti... or I keep saying anti-grav. I don't mean anti-grav. Ludo Strange Attractor seems kind of bad because they keep, like, dipping in and out of the range of it. It's very weird. Obviously, Nun's Habit is a great item. If we could buy it, I would like to be able to buy it. I don't think we're going to be able to buy it, though. We have nothing ready to reroll here, because we keep getting damage upgrades. No skulls in there, unfortunately. Well, we will continue exploring, then. I'm just going to hang out as far away from, like, every enemy as we can. Really, like, one of the reasons that I'd like to become Guppy is obviously to generate as many flies as possible and get a little extra damage in that regard. But also, I would... just love to be able to fly so that I can stay far, far away. I'm trying to see if it's raining, Kate.
No. I realized you left my sweater in the dryer.
I did? Yeah. Oh my god, I'm sorry. Did you get it?
No, not again.
Oh, I hope it's okay. Well, this lust is not really doing too much here. This lust is having a stroke on me. Strength card. That's not really going to help. Well, maybe. Balls of Steel will, though. We'll take the Strength card with us. It actually could help in the future. I was being a little bit flippant in my criticism of the strength card. With the amount of HP we have, this might actually be kind of a nice touch. So let's put one over here. And I think it has to be here then. Okay, very good. We get some pills. Balls of steel. I'm very bad about remembering the actual... Oh, that's not great. I'm bad about remembering what the pill effects actually are. Based on their color. And... Bad gas? Well, that's just not very good. I'm not gonna go to the mob trap room. I'm a little bit nervous about our, anxious. Nervous is probably not the right word. I'm a little bit... anxious about our, overall, killing power. But I think we've got a pretty good chance at a deal with the devil on this floor, and if we're able to make that happen, who knows what kind of greatness might befall us in the future. Red chest? That's a golden... Ah, we should do it. Let's pop our strength card just to make it a little easier. Like, the enemies are behaving somewhat unpredictably as a result of the combination of items we have here. And this is really, I mean, it's what I desire all the time. What I'm kind of hoping for here, strangely enough, is you know, if we could get triple shot or something, doesn't that give us, I know this sounds incredibly dumb, but I think that gives us a second shot that kind of orbits our existing one. I think chocolate milk plus Ludo maybe gives you really low rates of actually ticking damage. So a tiers upgrade or a really, really high tiers item you know, I'm not going to necessarily say the S word, soy milk, but it's two words as well. But, you know, skinny odd mushroom maybe does carry a small damage downgrade, but I think that's the kind of thing we can afford to absorb right now. It would also help to have more ticks if we're actually going to be able to generate flies as a result of becoming Guppy. We've got kind of a very ramshackle setup. It doesn't seem weak, it just doesn't seem as strong as it could be. We got a good base, shall we say, for things in the future. Yes, there is a blood bank there. You are correct, sir. Now, stay away. We're doing Apollo 13 slingshots around the moon here. I don't want to do that. I just want to keep the bomb flies as far away from me as is conceivably possible. Explosive diarrhea. We only have one bomb, so there is, you know, there's something to be said about this. This is a dead end, which I did not expect. Well, this should be relatively easy. I wonder if, range... I don't know if it works like this, so it might already work like this, and it would be cool if it did. But how cool would it be if your range with magnetic tears affected the range at which... That wouldn't make any sense. It would only make sense, hard-coded in this specific instance. But how cool would it be if it affected the magnetic range? So, the larger your range stat was, the closer enemies, or the further away enemies could be and still be affected by, your gravitational pull. That would be cool. It's not gravitational pull, it's a magnetic pull. Andre Ampere is not going to be very happy with me. That's okay. Andre Ampere's magical, mystical, wonderful law of Maxwell's equations. It is the longest and strangest of all. That's, if you got that reference, kudos to you, because that is just nonsense. In 12th grade physics class, a friend of mine and I, we had to choose Maxwell's equations, which are these, you know, landmark equations in physics. For electromagnetism. We had to choose one of them, so we chose Ampere's law, and basically our whole presentation was man, if you're in you're a senior in high school and you're not a genius, there is basically I thought you were trapped there. There is basically no way for you to possibly understand Ampere's law. So we were here's a song. It goes it started when you multiplied the right side by mu sub epsilon, a novel quality. And we're what the fuck are you talking about? It ended mu not epsilon not divided by the time derivative of phi sub e. And everyone was what? Same here. Headless baby. Dark bum. Well, I'm stoked to have gotten dark bum, especially in combination with little Chad. With Curse of Blindness, there was no way for us to know, unfortunately, if any of these were going to be, Guppy items. So I figured at one heart, you know, the Guppy items are all one heart, we'd take them. I think we ended up getting a decent deal with it anyway. Now, to make the, incredibly long, arduous trek with one HP to our, item room down there, where we'll hopefully be able to either get a great item or use our reroll to get a great item. Fuck this room. I've had worse situations on this room, but this one's not going to be very good. Does Strange Attractor not attract bullets? If it did, like, that plus shielded tears would be so cool. Strange architecture. It's alright. I feel the need to sing a little bit, which is bad for everybody. But I feel it because, you know, these rooms are going to be taking some time to perfect their beats, and I know they still have love for the streets. It's the DRE. I don't know how I feel about this run just yet. You know, I roll the dice as often as possible, and, I mean, not literally. I've taken many opportunities not to roll the dice on this run. Yep, I had a feeling that might happen. That's okay. We can save that black card. We might even be able to farm up a bunch here, but we can save that black card for, the future. What I should have done there is, yeah, exactly what I did on the second life and kind of just, like, trapped him in there with my magnetic love. That's for you, Dark Bomb. Well, in a way, that death is going to provide us with a pretty nice baseline of HP for future floors. I walked on the fucking spike. That doesn't feel good. Where's my black card from Monkey's Paw? It's all right. People so often think that, like, that guarantees a loss, but it really doesn't. Oftentimes, it just is. It sets the stage for a win in the future. I think we can actually afford to keep the bullet kind of close to these skulls, because it doesn't tick up that much. Did you see the speed bonus which we gave his bullet there? That was kind of ridiculous. Apparently they're only affected by them when they stand up, which makes no sense. So I think we're going to buy, let's hold off, because we might want to buy the battery. Spider bite. This is a great item. So we don't need to buy the battery, so what we'll buy is the spirit heart. Just to guarantee that we kind of stay alive and in relatively good health, thanks to those. Because we do want to get deals with the devil in the future. And with only one bomb, I'm not going to stress out about trying to find the secret room. The thing about this run that I was saying is, like, I feel okay about it, but not amazing thus far, is because... Well, let's see if there's a demon judgment. No. No demon judgment. I know there was a penny on the ground. We should go back for it. I'm lazy, though. Mom, I'm lazy. Well, we can't. No secret rooms on those locations. You wanna? Let's try to use like one bomb here. It was a shot in the dark. It didn't really work out that well. Like we have synergies that could be cool. I really feel like we're just lacking like one item to tie it all together. Spider bite might be a start, honestly. But I really think that it's kind of like tears upgrades are what we need. Strangely enough. Oh, yeah, Dark Bum. Go to town on it. For a second, I thought this was a dead end, and I guess I just assumed that that would be the end of our run, because that would have been two dead ends. Would have been trapped. I'm going to use a key here. Red chests could be nice. Red HP. Red chests would be nice as well. Ooh, that's not guppy. That's okay. You know, good things come to those who wait. Although, I really feel like in the most recent patches, they might have nerfed some guppy spawn rates. Or maybe it's just, it could totally be like observer bias as well. Confirmation bias. Look, I don't know what those biases mean. All I know is that that's what people always say when they think that something that is not statistically actually happening is statistically happening. So I'm hoping... That it... Well, you know what? Honestly, I don't care if it has been nerfed or not. I just want to know. The only way to know that definitively is to trust that they would have put it in the patch notes. Which I assume they would have. But maybe they're having a little bit of a giggle. They're saying, oh, you think it's too easy to become guppy? Check this out, motherfuckers. 99 bombs seems like a really nice way to hedge our bets when there's a realistic chance that my tears just become completely unusable in the late game. Who knows, though? If we get like Polyphemus... Or, God forbid, something like Brimstone. I think we would have, like, maybe one of the most incredible runs I've ever had here. Controllable Brimstone, you know, wormhole, basically. There is a battery here, so I'm going to reroll these. And, I don't really like any of these, to be honest with you. But I'm going to save at least 5 cents. We'll see if we can get to at least 850. I'd feel relatively good about the run if we could get to 850. Even if we did lose. There's 850. I know we're not on the last floor, by the way. We're only on Depths 1. I want to save, yeah, enough money to buy this battery, because we're going to go back to our shop right now. Or, not our shop, sorry, our boss room. I would be stupid to not activate extinguish those blue fires, given the chance that they could actually give me a spirit heart. Probably 2 spirit hearts on average. I think they have like a 1 in I think they have like a 50% chance of paying out, actually. Maybe that's a little optimistic. Alright, Gish. Well, we're not going to reroll Gish. Although, I will admit, I think in Rebirth, I can or could reroll Gish. We're going to use some bombs here because I think we would be very silly not to. And as you can see, like, our damage leaves a little bit to be desired here. But the bombs are doing what bombs do. And if we use 10 of them to beat Gish, that really does not matter in the least. I would be happy with it. As long as we don't get hit, as long as we give ourselves the best possible deal with the devil chance, life's good. Probably two more will be enough. Oh, one more, okay. No deal with the devil. I'm not fully surprised by that. Sure. We'll take a little Gish. I was thinking about it, but what am I hoping to reroll it into? I guess the problem with little Gish is that I don't really have much likelihood of shooting that much. Although every time I move my tier in a direction, little Gish will shoot. But I think it's pretty unlikely that I'll actually be shooting in the direction of the enemy. Now that we have so many bombs, let's check this out. And we'll check this out. I do agree somewhat with the anecdotal advice that second secret rooms tend to be around boss rooms. I might be mistaken, but we're gonna head down to the next floor. I know we skipped a lot of this floor, but it's we went to the major rooms. Mostly I'm hoping to find some red chests. I probably will fight that. I find those stone chests intriguing. Fate for free is fantastic. Why does this item show up for free so often? It's amazing. Sincerely, like, it's one of those items that really seems to show up like once every two runs. It's like, here's a free fate. And now I'm hoping we get a deal with the devil because I'd like to get rid of 1 HP so that we can... Nope, okay. So that we can have permanent Polaroid invincibility, which might end up being relatively important. Now that we can fly, we're in a very, very good position. Let's see what we got inside of here. It's a red chest that is not a guppy item, but, you know, it did pay for itself here. So I'm not overly annoyed, but I will admit that, you know, giving us those guppy items early and then not giving us the Holy Trinity, it's a bit cruel. I feel. Dark Bum working out very nicely for us. Remember, this is on hard mode, so you'd expect this to be a little bit, like Dark Bum to be a little bit less useful than on normal. I don't think we need the magnet. I think Fear Shot is fantastic. It's not as good as Dark Matter, but it's okay. And again, this should be a pretty likely, floor for a Guppy setup. Let's see if we've got anything but greed in our shop. I think that a shop greed is probably something that we'd be likely to see. You remember that Our Lady Peace... Do people outside of Canada know about Our Lady Peace? You remember that Our Lady Peace jam? Shop greed! Shop... That was Starseed, not Navid. That would be, come, come, shop greed. Anyway. Well, I mean, we have no reason not to spend money here. So why don't we buy the PhD? I'm not going to reroll the Bible because I don't intend to... Well, we don't have anything else. We got two health upgrades. Thank you, PhD. We'll take those. Even though I was talking about permanent Polaroid invincibility earlier. And, well, there's... I can see forever. That's pretty useful. Range upgrade. That's pretty useful. I can't play that because we'll lose our Eternal Heart, unfortunately. Let's go find our secret rooms, hopefully. And we might as well also go back to our... Oh, there's the secret room. Alright, two bombs. I gotta admit, that's kind of a little bit less bombastic than I expected the deal to be. Let's also open this up. I think there's a chance that this stone chest can pay out with a guppy item. I swear I've seen it, but it was maybe just because we were on a curse room. Okay, that could be a Joker card. It is a Joker card. So this becomes maybe one of our last possible cracks at getting a guppy item. Even if we don't get a guppy item, it seems like we're in a pretty nice position. We got like some mind control shit here. That's telekinesis, Kyle! I won't try to humiliate myself by trying to hit those Jack Black Tenacious D notes. I've been paying a lot of thought to it though. Alright, so Monstro 2, he's just in a fucking nightmare zone right now. And if you would just do me a favore and stay as far away as possible, everyone would be happier, I think, as a result of your actions. Dark Bum chose not to pay out, which I'm a little bit disappointed by. In the meantime, though, why don't we take a trip down here? Yeah, we can't gamble on that. And you know what? If we're not going to gamble on it, we might as well blow it up so that Dark Bum maybe can get a little bonus. Yeah, that's like one full spirit heart right there. This is, oh, one full black heart. This is shaping up to be a relatively easy and kind of novel win, so I'm a big fan of that. Certainly is the kind of thing that would not happen on a lost run. You guys, I took damage on like the second floor. Not happy with that damage either. Dark Bum paid out with a spider that then got killed. That was the first time we've seen Dark Bum pay out with a spider on this run, so you'll excuse me if I don't buy the myth that Dark Bum is all of a sudden really shitty as a result. I actually don't like Fear Shot on the Mom fight, especially Red Mom, because we unfortunately have to be able to predict where the foot's gonna land. This is actually going to be a slower Red Mom fight than normal, because we're really going to have only a very brief period, I should say, to be able to do the kind of damage that I'd like to do. We're actually fairly lucky if we even get like one tick in here. And again, you know, I'm starting to think that I probably should have rerolled Little Gish, because it's very rare that Little Gish is actually able to do what needs to be done. So I'm just like, the way that this is working is assuming like equal or normal periods here. Where's the foot? Come on, there we go. Every time the foot goes up, that was bad. I'm swapping my position with the bullet, which should give me, you know, the bullet will be where I just was, and then I'll be where the bullet just was, and then we'll just swap back like that. Okay, we did get a deal with the devil. I shouldn't have picked that up. We will take the Polaroid. We're gonna be fighting Krampus. Oh my god, how did that... I don't understand. If this is magnetic, how is it pushing it away? It should be sucking it in. I know that there's magnets and, you know, opposites attract, yada yada, whatever. Guppy's hairball. There we go. We became Guppy. That's a big dream come true for us. I'm not salty, despite the fact that we got Fate on this floor. Two abilities to fly is better than one. Not really, but that's okay. Curse of the Maze. You know what? Let's pop our Joker card right away. See if we get anything useful in here. I don't really see a reason not to. Our deal with the devil sucked. The big one. Let's try to make our way towards the boss fight here. Did you find your sweater, Cade?
Yes.
All right, that's good. I didn't even know it was down there.
It was on top of the dryer.
It was on top of the dryer? It's never going to get dry on top of the dryer.
It's not supposed to be a dryer.
Oh, it's a hang dry.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I wouldn't know that because I only wear the same, like, H&M hoodie in two different colors for my entire winter season. Hansel, so hot right now. Okay, this is bad damage. That's all right, though. This is what I was hoping for, because now you can see the value. I mean, you could probably guess the value of having Guppy before, but we can pretty much just hang out over the gaps, and even though our magnetic bullshit doesn't do that much damage, the flies are strong enough en masse to do a lot of work on our enemies here. And if we can get a nice fly army going, this seems like a great choice for us, by the way. I didn't mean to pick up one of those red hearts, but I figured, yeah, we can get two spirit hearts. We only got one. I think we got a friendly spider. That's okay, though. That's worthless. I'm assuming this is... No, it is the right way to get to the boss. So see, yeah, like we can just hang out way over here. And what's nice about the flies is that even if you're on the other side of the map, the flies just know, man. That was an incredibly good snipe with that fire. I can't even be mad there. But the flies just know where to go in order to do extra damage here. Yeah, well, sometimes. They were a little wonky there. I have lost a little more HP than I'd care to admit here. Should blow up some red hearts, you know. Or it should blow up some polyps so that I can get some extra spirit hearts, but that's okay. Doesn't truly matter all that much. Especially with all these good pills. We'll save that for the next floor because we're done with this one, basically. Teratomo, I am so sorry. You have almost no ability to survive here. Even though we took a lot of damage on this floor, you know, we're going to be in a good position. Happy we got an HP upgrade there. And I'm very excited to see what kind of bullshit we can get up to on the chest, because we're relatively carried right now. Call me crazy. I kind of feel like a pill called I Can See Forever should also allow you to see the... like everything on the level, like it should be a world card, but that would be way too easy, but it bugs me because I'd like to be able to know where to go, but that's on me. No? Wow, no spirit hearts on four of those. I am a little surprised. Also, curse rooms, not really working out for us quite as well as I would hope. That's okay, though. It has still been a very strong run. And, you know, Dark Bum when necessary, is helping out. We won't be able to get into our special boss room here. I say this a lot, but one of the best tips I can give you if you're having a guppy run and you can fly or you have like high mobility, stay as far away as you can. I really thought we'd get hit on the movement there. Stay as far away from the enemies as you can, and just let yourself build up a huge fly army, because then when you go fight the boss, it pays dividends. You'll end up, having like 20 or 30 flies that will just shit all over the boss. And you basically encounter no penalty as a result of it. It's for you, Dark Bomb. Every spirit heart counts. Of course, there's some rooms where you can't control how many of your flies actually end up using themselves to kill something, like this one. They just kind of feast on the carcass there. There is a tinted rock over here. It's like the first tinted rock I've found all game. Probably a result of my own... I don't want to say idiocy. What I want to say is like my own lack of attention to detail, which is still insulting, but is more true and perhaps a diplomatic insult as opposed to just like quite rude. So there we go. Mom's heart was very easy. Up to the cathedral. I imagine the cathedral is going to be relatively easy for us as well. The chest might be a little tougher, but we should also get some cool items on the way. Looks like it's down. But I've been to a lot of cathedrals in Isaac in my day, and my guess is that we probably have to go through that big room to get here. Not this one, but the one that I skipped by coming this way. Maybe not, actually. This might be a very straightforward cathedral, which would be awesome. Nope. Just when I thought I was out, game sucked me back in again. Yeah, you stay there. It's okay. Now I'm starting to come around to the idea of our magnetic tears. Yeah. I'm starting to come around to the idea of our magnetic tears, because we're guppy, and the flies actually have, like, really good kind of, like, aggro behavior. Like, they know where to go. They go basically wherever they spawned, or whatever enemy they spawned from, that's where they visit. So it's actually... Oh, no, don't shoot them yet. All the flies are going to waste themselves not even attacking the haunt. Oh, this is bad. We got to get, like, both of those haunts active. This is not a good... room layout for us. There we go. But what I'm trying to say in a very roundabout way is that we kind of like pin them in place with the ants or the magnetic tiers, and then the flies just do work. So we can just kind of hang out over top of these rocks, and you know, the enemies never chase us down. We never find ourselves in a problematic position as a result. It feels pretty good. Doesn't hurt having PhD in situations like this. And I should let Dark Bum get that heart. You never know when one spirit heart may or may not make the difference. Not that we could even take spirit hearts down to the next floor right now, but might as well. Well, I paid out with an angry spider anyway. You ruined it, Edmund. You ruined it. Dark Bum used to be so good, and now he's just like really, really, really good, but not quite as good. Almost. Hematemesis will probably save for a little bit later. What kind of stuff am I hoping for from the chest? I would love to see shielded tiers. I would love to see any tier effect, honestly. And especially if we get like any tier effect combined with Luckfoot, so that we can see that tier effect like more often. Like, I don't know if Tough Love would work for us, but that could be cool. Fire Mind is one for sure. I don't really want Curved Spoon. I always call it Curved Spoon. Spoonbender. I don't really want Spoonbender. But tier effects, by and large, are things that I'd be interested in. Apart from that, high damage items, Polyphemus, Brimstone plus Ludo is something I don't think I've ever had. Which could be interesting, especially with Magnetic going on, but this is just a fairly textbook win right here. Well, not textbook, but a fairly nice win. So Samson's Chains is fine. Unknown is very interesting. What was that? Unicorn Stump. Well, I mean, okay, Unicorn Stump is probably great for us. This is a weird one, though, because I want to keep Unknown. I guess what I'll do is I'll try to find some more red chests. Or, sorry, not red chests, but I'll try to find some more chests out here so I can kind of deposit Unknown at them and then reroll everything else. But for now, because I don't want to reroll Unknown because it leads to cool situations. So I know it seems like I'm wasting my opportunities by not rerolling it straight away. We can always get one reroll out of it just before the end if we want to. But for now, I'm hoping that we get a payout in the form of, like, another chest. One of the most common places to find those, by the way, is in a secret room. So, you know, there is some value in using Unknown right away. Well, if we're going to use unknown, why don't we use unknown right away? Because then I won't be able to do anything with my D6. Right, got it. All right, I understand. I think I should start using unknown straight away, though. And we'll, you know, we won't get too attached to the D6. We'll say, thank you for your service, D6. We have a more interesting item at our disposal right now. It also means we won't be able to do anything with Unicorn Stump, sadly. So we'll take unknown, or undefined, and start using it. And there's an Eternal Heart, and we're right next to our boss room, but we're not going to go to it yet, because that would be lame and lazy, and, you know, you don't always get undefined on the chest, so it would be nice to use it a little bit more frequently, if it's at all possible. No! You blew him up! I was excited to see what that guy was going to give us in the tarot card form. Alright, so we need 4 more rooms to have a chance at getting, our secret, or our I Am Error room. It should be fairly likely. Empress, probably better than Hematemesis. If we're not going to have any risk of dying anyway, why not just have a little bit of a damage bonus on a very special room? Is that my creep? That's my creep. Okay. 2 more rooms. We are going to be able to do it here. I'd like to get War killed before anything else. It has been done. I would like to get Famine killed before anything else. It has been done. What is up with, like, the complete lack of chests? Work with me here. We have scared the shit out of the Haunt. It's always nice when you walk into the room and for once the Haunt is scared of you, not the other way around. Alright, so he should just stay still and we'll just, you know, do our taxes over here. We're good. No chests still. Unknown. That is the error room. Sure. Suck them all in, baby. We got another charge on unknown straight away. Oh my god, Infestation 2, so good. Oh man, that's a new item. So we're getting something there. The body, I feel all. That seems to have given me like full HP. Why not take a speed upgrade? We're gonna get a little ridiculous here. That's not an item. And what's this card? 2 of clubs. Well, we'll pop that. I don't really want to take Hematemesis with me, so I'll take the Empress and we'll just go. And then we'll open these golden chests, and then we'll use Unknown again. There you go. See, Unknown actually provided something constructive for us on this run. It allowed us to get a new item we've never seen. Sad Bomb, Punching Bag, Rosary. Oh, yeah. Okay, so Death's Touch, unfortunately, doesn't give us the effect of it. But it does give, it gives us the damage, but it doesn't give us any visual effect. I bet those do a lot of damage. We might as well pick up the Rosary. Let's use Unknown. Gives us another Eternal Heart, which is effectively worthless. This is exactly the same layout for this floor. I guess you always get the same layout. Interesting. Infestation 2 plus Guppy here is just absurd. Like, we're going to be able to do so much... I'm going to make the same mistake again. We're going to be able to do so much damage with our flies and spiders. I love it. I like it. I love it. I want some more of it. I was watching Mathis Games play Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Motherfucker said, I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. It's a little bit hypocritical because I didn't come up with the song, but I was the first one of the two of us to reference the song. What are you doing there, Matt Haz? You owe me, like, at least 14 YouTube dollars as a result of that. YouTube dollars, they have a different currency conversion rate. That's not going to break the bank. Alright, this will be another room for us to get our unknown or undefined charge. I'm just going to call it unknown because I can't be trusted to learn the real name. Please work. Please work. It did not work. I thought it did for a second. I got very excited. We should still have one more opportunity if I had to guess. Does Infestation 2 only work when an enemy dies? Is that what makes it like maybe not quite as good as the Mulligan? If so, that... I mean, it sucks a little bit, but those spiders are still real strong, though. I gotta admit, you know, the adversaries, he's holding up a little bit better than I would have thought. I guess we exhausted our fly army earlier somehow. We'll just keep moving constantly. Ah, we did decent damage. Like, our tiers still kind of suck, but, the spiders and flies are holding it down, no question about it. We can always fight Blue Baby to get our final charge and then try to do the entire floor again. Because I'm all about these weird runs. Plus, who knows? There's another item I think we have not gotten yet. You know, Zero Baby or something? Or was that... maybe that's only available in co-op? I'm not totally sure. I mean, the babies are co-op items. No, except for, like, you know, Ghost Baby, Robo Baby, etc., etc. I gotta admit, I'm taking a little bit more damage than I'd otherwise be comfortable with. Two rooms. I think I took that by accident. Should have let... Oh, actually, Dark Bum is now worthless for us, right? I forgot about that, because we don't have any space for Spirit Art, so Dark Bum is effectively just dead weight. That's sad. Great item, or once great item, I should say, is now fallen by the wayside a little bit. We might need that money. Who knows if there's like an otherworldly shop or something that appears sometime soon. If we kill Blue Famine last, we should get a Spirit Heart, which is meaningless now that I think about it. Right, it's hard to get out of that habit. All right, undefined. That is not an error room. So I think at this point we kind of got to fight the boss. I apologize for this being a little bit of a truncated undefined run, but you know, I expected it to pay out a little bit better than it did. That's okay, shit happens. Let's pop our Empress card. Throw down some sad bombs, see how much damage they do. Eh, not quite as much as I'd thought, actually. We'll see if the bullets actually hit. They probably help out a little bit more though. Well, relatively easy win, all things considered. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the run. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.